사실 그러한 가운데 이제 프리 라이젠이 생각하는 한 사회에서 사실 예술의 역할이란 무엇이어야지 되는지 여쭙고 싶습니다.
It's I'm not an academic and I'm not a theoretician, so I can only give my personal view on this. We all live in societies that are super, super demanding and are super, super busy and are super, super hectic. From morning till evening, we are all rushing, working, doing things. And we have very little time to stop, look at the world, look at our society, and reflect on it. And I think that's why we as a society, we are willing to invest in people that we just ask, please, you do this. You look at our society, you analyze it, you criticize it, and you develop a vision that is bringing us somewhere else that could change the lives of everybody. And these people is the artists, the real ones, not the fake ones, are the jerkers. So as a society, we invented a system that a part of our tax money that we pay to the government is dedicated for people to reflect on the time we live in and on the societies we live in, and to show us where it hurts, to show us what is not so well in our societies. And that show us also, that tell us also what is the, how little creatures we are as human beings. We live in a society where everybody has to be the best, the first, the biggest, the winner, we all this. And it is not true. We are not winners. We are just ridiculous little beings who try our best, but we are not all the most beautiful and the strongest and the most clever. We are not. This is not true. But it's important that an artist points it out to us, not insulting us that we are just little chicken, but showing us the beauty of this frailty of being a human being and how fragile we are. And even if we have good intentions, we fail all most of the time. But to deal with this frailty and to accept it and to see it as something beautiful, that is also what an artist can offer me. The world we live in is very, very, very complex. And to survive in this complex world, we have a tendency to simplify things. And simplifying things means that we use clichés. Otherwise, we tend to get lost in this world. It's too much, it's too complex, it frightens us. So we have clichés, we have preset ideas, and they comfort us, and with this we think we can live well. And artists, for me, they show me, Madame Leysen, your clichés don't work. It's not like this. The reality is different. And you cannot simplify what is complex. You have to accept the complexity and live with that. And inspire me and offer me a vision that can change my ideas, that can change my way of thinking, and so can also change my way of living. And this is a kind of counterweight in our society where we have this tendency to simplify things, and also what the political world is doing most of the time, they create fear in our heart. Creating fear in our hearts is the best political weapon to make us like little doggies, quiet and obedient. That is politically organized. You have to be aware and you have to fear everything that's different from us. And this is a sickening infection in our society. looking at yourself in the mirror is getting boring very quick. But looking at somebody else who is different, who has different ideas, who speaks different languages, who has a different background, who has a different history, who has a different religion, this is inspiring for me. This I can get something from. This I'm curious to know. And that's what we have to do in the arts also. It's opening up to say, okay, this is your perspective of seeing the world, but what does it mean when you look through the eyes of somebody else to this world? If you change your perspective, you see something different. And that is what that I need, and I think the audience needs.
Question. 이제 한국에서 동시대 예술, 그러니까 컨템포러리 아트, 이렇게 하면은 처음에 나오는 얘기들이 난해하다, 어렵다, 일부 소수만을 위한 건데 그것이 왜 우리가 세금으로 지원을 해가지고서는 이거를 우리가 해야 할 만한 가치가 있는 것인가, 이런 것들에 대한 많은 의문과 질문들이 있습니다. 이에 대해서는 어떻게 보시는지 궁금합니다.
It's not only in Korea. It's all over the world like this. I think we have to make a difference between, and this is maybe sometimes a confusion all over the world, what is art, what is culture, and what is entertainment. Entertainment is to entertain people. It's commercial, and it doesn't really need taxpayers' money because it makes money. You can make a lot of money with entertainment. I'm not against entertainment. It's very fine that it exists, and sometimes we need to relax and to have a real entertaining evening. That's perfectly okay. Culture is a very large idea of lifestyle even, while the arts is this very specific field that I was talking about just before now. And this is what for me is, when you look at the big companies in the world, they produce a lot of stuff and commercialize it. But to be able to do this, they have one section in their organization that is called research and development. This section eats a huge amount of money. It is the research and development section that eats a lot of investment, but it is necessary because there new inventions are made, new products are developed and are developed so that they can be produced and be commercialized. Of course, our society is not an enterprise, but I just make the parallel that we need in our society this department that is thinking and developing philosophy and finding out new artistic languages and developing new ideas how to deal with new changing societies constantly. And that is what the role of the arts for me is in this society.
그 동시대 예술이 어렵다는 그런 비판, 그 다음에 그것이 대중이 아닌 소수의 엘리트만을 위한 그러한 비판, 이런 것들에 대해서 어떻게 생각하시는지 답변을 다시 요청합니다.
I would like to say two things on this. First of all, and it may be shocking, but I'm not against elites. I'm against elites when it becomes a small incestuous group, a clan that is closed up, then I'm against it. But I'm not against an elite that tries to be as big and as open as possible. Then I really defend the elite. So to reach a bigger audience is not, the good way is not to take the level of the program down, not at all, but it's to communicate in a different way to people so that they all feel that everybody feels addressed and that everybody feels invited and that everybody can be part of this big, big elite. Contemporary art is art that is made today by people that live today, addressing audiences that live today, and reflecting on a world how it is today, and where it came from, and where it's heading to. And the question whether we need it or not is, for me, completely irrelevant, because it will always be there. People will always create artworks, always, in a language that is the language of today, and reflecting on a society as it is today, on human beings as they are today. And I'm not saying that the past is not important. For me, the past is part of today. Today is carrying the whole past with it and trying to imagine a future.
이것은 이제 저희가 그동안 한국에서 극장을 운영한다는 것들이 사실은 극장에서 제작 기능보다는 집만 지어놓고 일단은 이미 만들어진 작품들을 극장에서 보여주는 식의 극장 운영이었다면 나름대로 그 최초로 그 제작이라는 거를 그 전면에 내세운 그런 극장 운영을 이제 저희가 하게 되면서 이제 저 개인한테도 상당히 그 질문이 제기된 부분입니다. 그래서 이제 극장을 운영할 때에 이제 그 작품을 보여준다는 것은 크게 두 가지 방법론이 있을 텐데요. 하나는 이미 만들어진 작품, 이미 완성도가 있는 작품인 걸 가지고 이제 극장에서 보여주게 되면은 사실은 이미 완성도가 있는 것을 확인하고 가지고 오니까 이미 그만큼 그 위험 부담을 최소화할 수 있는데 사실은 작가를 발굴한다는 거, 작가에게 기회를 준다는 거, 이 작가에게 미래를 제공한다는 거 그러기 위해서 이제 제작이라는 것들이 필요한데 그런 제작 극장을 한다는 의미, 그런 작가들의 제작을 작품의 제작을 한다는 의미. 그리고 그런 위험 부담을 갖는다는 의미가 무엇인지 선배로서 얘기를 해주셨으면 좋겠습니다.
When you look at very good artists, they make maybe 3-4 masterpieces in their life, which is a lot already. Then they make a lot of okay work, and then they make bad work too, you know. It's not a machine. But a not so good production of an interesting artist will always be more interesting than a well-made production of a non-interesting artist. But it's a big risk for a theater to invest in creating a new production, but it's also a big risk for an audience to buy a ticket to come and see a new production. And this is very important, that we go back to this adventurous position and that this curiosity, and art is not consumer goods. And it's not because you buy a ticket that you have bought 1000% quality. I hope that if you buy a ticket, you see something that is worthwhile seeing it. But I will never tell you that this is the masterpiece of a century you're going to see. But you will meet an interesting person. And this consumerism attitude in the arts, I think we have to fight against a bit. And be adventurous. When you go and travel, you don't know what you will be seeing behind the corner in the next street. This is a kind of, you trust and you take the risk and you take this adventurous trip in the arts.
Personal. 그 프리는 이제 유럽 사람이지만 그 수많은 비서구권의 예술가들과 작업한 것으로 알려져 있습니다. 그 비서구권에 대한 관심을 어떻게 생겼으며 지금 그 당신 지난 20, 30년간 목격한 것은 무엇인지 그다음에 그 프리의 눈으로 본 아시아와 비서구권의 예술계의 변화들이 알고 싶은데요.
Europe has had for many years the idea that we had the monopoly of artistic cultural values, I think things are changing now. And I feel when I was in the Arab world, we discussed a lot because they were all quoting European philosophers and Deleuze and blah, blah, blah. And I said, but where are your philosophers? Where is the Arab history of contemporary art? What are your standards? They are different from the Europeans. And I feel the same in Asia. And I like a lot that in the world today, this awakeness is coming all over the place, so that people are not just accepting this hegemony of the West, but are getting much more self-confident about their culture and their background and their standards and their sensitivities and their philosophies and their aesthetics. And I think this will make the world for the future, for the world to come, will be so much more interesting. You said it in an interview once, there is not one center in the world, but there must be different centers, different artistic centers that are different. They are different because they are located in different places with each a different history and a different religion and economy and politics and everything you want. But what unites us is that the time we live in is now. And that is what unites us. And when you have this cement that is the time, that is today, and you have the differences from all these different places in the world, that is fantastic. For me, that's the future I dream of.